Trini Girl Natural.
Hi everyone, I wanted to come on today to talk to you about scalp massages. So it's almost wash day and my goal is to do a scalp massage once a week with my pre-poo. So I like to kill two birds with one stone, so you always hear me trying to do two things at once, you know, if it's kind of possible to combine them. And the first thing I like to combine is my scalp massage and my pre-poo. So first of all, scalp massages are really good for your scalp and for hair growth because they help to stimulate the scalp, which helps to stimulate hair growth. And I think they're also good for just releasing stress and just relaxing because I find them so pleasant and so relaxing. So, you know, try it out. Even if you don't see the growth, you will see the benefits from just the relaxation and just that you time with your hair. So, how to do a scalp massage. So I'm going to do a demo where I kind of show you clips of what I do, but I wanted to like talk a little bit first about what are the important things to know when doing a scalp massage. So first of all, you want your hair to be not too wet, not too dry. You don't want it to be crunchy, but you don't want it to be like sopping wet at the end either. And this is especially true if you're trying to combine it with a pre-poo and you're trying to do an overnight oil pre-poo. So you don't want to go to bed with like soaking wet hair. And just feel it, if it's like too dry, you just spritz it with a little bit of water and then you get your oil. The next thing to note is that you can kind of do three things in one by warming your oil a little bit. So oil is good. Warm oil is even better in terms of like stimulating your scalp and just helping the oils to penetrate. If you feel like it and you have the time, you can just boil some water and then put a little glass container with oil in the water and you just kind of swirl it around and then like keep shaking it up, swirling it around until the oil warms. I don't do anything super hot, but you know your business. If you, whatever temperature you like to do your hot oil treatments at, you can do this at. So your hair is good, not too dry, not too wet. Your oil is warm if you're not lazy. If you're lazy, your oil is cool, which is totally fine. And then on to the scalp massaging. The important thing to know about scalp massaging, first of all, is that you're not rubbing your fingers on your scalp like this. You are putting your fingers to your scalp and then you are moving your whole entire scalp. You know, like that. It's not like if you're scrubbing, no, everything is moving. So I think a lot of people are confused about that, and I see a lot of people talk about, you know, they're trying to massage their edges and it's like coming off more, and it's probably because they're not massaging it the right way. So definitely, fingers to scalp, move scalp. And the more relaxed you are, the more your scalp can move. So right up in there is just relax. If you need to close your eyes and hum, whatever you need to do, just relax. So this is, when my scalp is tense, you know what, this is how much I can get. You know, it doesn't really go very far, but if I relax, goes a lot further. See? Relaxed. Tense. You know, I'm trying for yourself. I'm not just making motions. If you try it for yourself, you'll see. The more relaxed you are, the more you can move your scalp, the more effective your scalp massage is going to be. So the next thing to note is that you don't have to get every single inch of your scalp. Near to where your fingers touch are also going to be stimulated. So your finger touch is going to kind of radiate outward. And near to that area is also going to be stimulated. So you don't want to just put your hand like in one spot, especially if your head's kind of big, like mine. So, but you don't have to get every single inch either. So you know, you just do, you do, you do, you know, until you get everything covered. So, and pay special attention to your edges and maybe your crown, whatever your fragile areas are, you want to pay more attention to that. So you don't need to drown yourself in oil. You can just like dip your fingers in the oil or just wet your fingers with the oil and do the massage. Especially if you're not going to shampoo the next day or something. Just dip it and, you know, if you are going to shampoo the next day, you can be more liberal. Especially if you're using coconut oil and trying to prevent high growth fatigue and so on. That only works if you get it on your strands. So what I usually do is kind of do a little bit first. Just do my scalp massage first, basically. And then put some more oil in my hands and like smooth down my hair. And do the pre-poo part afterwards. Once you're finished kind of massaging everywhere like I showed you, the next thing you can do is tap with your fingers to stimulate the scalp some more. So I know a lot of people now use a vibrating brush, but if you're relatively tool-free like me, you may be a little bit wary of them. So I mean, I haven't decided how I feel about them yet, but you know, I don't really use combs or brushes. Like every 6 months I might use a Denman brush just before I go to get my hair trimmed. I might use a comb every other week just to part my hair and that's it. So I'm not too sure yet about just the vibrating brush and all the fun angles. I see, you know, they were like giving it away, so like a whole bunch of YouTubers were just suddenly loving that scalp brush. So, you know, if that's you, instead of using your fingers, I'm trying to figure out if that is gonna work. But anyway, like I would still use my fingers to do the actual scalp massage because I don't see a brush really moving your scalp like I showed you. The brush is probably rubbing out your hair like I told you not to do. So, yeah, I don't know about that. But for the part where you just want to stimulate your scalp, you can like pat it with your fingers like this. And this really works especially after a massage, like, you know, just patting. So this really stimulates the scalp, especially after you relax from a massage. Or, you know, if you have a vibrating brush, you could just kind of put it, you know, place it and just, you know, get your little vibrations all over your scalp to stimulate. Now I'm going to say something that really might be controversial in the natural hair community. My first controversial statement. You really shouldn't be doing scalp massages on a clean scalp. The reason being, the sebum production naturally stops when you have enough sebum there, so that you don't drown yourself, I guess, you know? So as soon as you put something heavy like oil on your scalp, your sebum production is going to stop until you clean your scalp. So I never do it. I always do it like with my pre-poo. I do it before wash day. You know, if you want to do it more than once a week, at least give it a couple days after wash day where you already have some sebum. And again, you don't need to flood your scalp with oil. You can just oil your fingertips in and do it. A lot of people say that they have dry scalp issues, but they're actually giving themselves dry scalp issues because they're cutting off their sebum production because they're oiling their scalp on wash day. So your body's all confused and, you know, a lot of people do actually have genuine scalp issues. They've been to a dermatologist, but other people who have scalp issues are giving it to themselves by putting heavy products too close to their scalp. So if you want to wean away from oiling your scalp, I suggest using like aloe vera gel and using that to massage your scalp or moisturize your scalp instead of using oil. So that's lighter and that's going to evaporate faster and, you know, that's going to allow longer sebum production until eventually you can just kind of let your sebum do its thing. So at least by the end of the week, I wonder if I don't have any paper handy, but at least by the end of the week, and I guess I've been in here, you saw me, I didn't touch any oils. By the end of the week, my hands are oily, you know, they're not gunky, but they're oily because I have some sebum in there because I'm not messing with it, you know? I'm just explaining what science says and what's been working for me. And that if you are in that situation where you have dry scalp and you're always oiling your scalp, this could be something that you can try. Aloe vera gel, oil it maybe once or twice a week and just see what happens. Maybe I might free someone from dry scalp issue, then it'll be worth it. If you don't want to do it and you want to oil your scalp every day, all day, that's perfectly fine as well. For scalp massages and for pre-poos, you want to use penetrating oils. Coconut oil is good, like I said, it's special because it penetrates more than the other oils and it also helps to bind the protein to your hair, so it helps to keep your hair stronger longer. So I don't use pure coconut oil because it can have a drying effect. I mix it with olive oil or avocado oil or both. For your hair, for the pre-poo part, olive, avocado, and coconut is good. Vitamin E, castor, like stuff like that is good for your hair. For your scalp, you can use all of that and then just add a little bit of peppermint or rosemary to help stimulate the scalp. That helps give you that tingle and help stimulate your scalp without having any negative effect, you know. So, example, I didn't say tea tree oil because it is good for your scalp, but you don't want to overdo it. But in terms of like peppermint, you can kind of use it without worrying too much about that. So those are the oils that I recommend. Now I'm going to show you a slow demo of exactly how I do it. Place the oil in some recently boiled water and just shake and stir until it's warm. Spritz your hair if it's dry so that it's not too crunchy and it's kind of malleable. Then you start massaging. So I just oil my ends and edges and my fragile areas. So I make this massaging motion everywhere on my scalp. You can also make the motion in the top right corner. Then I just kind of pay special attention to my edges and go around and massage my edges. And I do that tapping motion to further stimulate my scalp. And that's pretty much it. For the pre-poo part, I add some oil on my ends if needed.
and smooth to release any shed hair. And then I just twist it up to stretch it. So I'm using a tie that I made myself. I just bought the ribbon on Amazon. After twisting, I just put on my bonnet and I'm ready for bed. And that's it.
Okay, so that was it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that was helpful. I can't say you're gonna get thick hair like me, because that's a lot of genetic, but you will most likely see improvement and you will definitely enjoy it. So good luck, happy massaging, and enjoy. See you in the next one. Bye.